Good morning to one and all present here, and a very warm welcome to all of you. Faith is taking the first step, even if we don't see the whole staircase. So, let us begin this function with the kind grace of God, the Almighty, to bless and fulfill our wishes in all our endeavors.
Shayo Chedi Parokshartasya Darshakam Sarvasya Lochanam Shastram Yasya Nastyande Eva Saha. Meaning of the shloka is, science breaks many doubts. It can help us see the invisible. Science is the eye for everyone to watch everything. The one without science is blind.
Albert Einstein once said, to raise new questions, new possibilities, to regard old problems from a new angle requires creative imagination and marks real advance in science. Life is water, dancing to the tune of solids. Am I mixing dance to science or science to dance? Let's give it out for an amazing performance by Vaishnavi from grade 8. Invite our acting principal Ratna ma'am to grace this event with her words.
A very good morning to all the little children present today, and the parents, teachers, and the guest of honor today, Mrs. Sowmya Raghuram, Principal, Glentree Academy, Sajapur. So there is a slight delay, so ma'am would be joining very soon. So I would take this opportunity to welcome all the parents to this exciting event, which is our first virtual science exhibition. With this event, we have unveiled the innovative creation of the students and also have developed a scientific rational thinking within the students. The projects are presented by individual students based on their research on certain topics given by their teachers. They have used their creativity and innovative ideas with the technology available. I was very, very excited and very happy to see the kind of projects that the little ones have done. And I know this would not have been possible without the support of the parents and our dear teachers. So I would like to thank all of you for contributing your time, the dedication and commitment of our teachers, parents, and students. So without taking much of your time, we would like to start off with today's virtual science exhibition. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. APJ Abdul Kalam once said, "Science is a beautiful gift to humanity. We should not distort it." On the special occasion of Science Day, we at Glentree Academy Whitefield would like to give an applaud to all the young, passionate, curious minds who will be the next future talent of our country.
Hello everybody, my name is Ananya. I am from class 1A. I have made a project called Model of Life Cycle of a Plant. First we sow the seed into the soil. Then the seed becomes into a sprout. Then the plant. Then it will grow and it will become a big plant with flowers. The honeybee pollinates, then it becomes into a fruit. From the fruit tree we get the fruit. From that we get the seed. Then the cycle starts all over again.
Natural things are like flowers, fruit, vegetables, or small rocks, like wood and nuts. in class 1. Today I am going to explain about land transport. Land transport is a transport that vehicles go on land. There are two types of land transport. One is road, another is railway transport.
Sheep is sharing his house with the donkey. See the next one. Cow's house. It's called shed. Then you see this. The dog's house. It's called kennel. Even I made biscuits for the dog. You see this pond. It's
tiger, lion, monkey, and leopard, deer, etc. Next, I am going to explain you about farm animals. Farm animals are the animals which live in human habitat. Some of the animals shown here are cow, sheep, horse, etc. The animals have
is a jungle where wild animals live, like elephant, like cheetah, like tiger, like moose. They need food and water. Thank you.
Today my topic is about moral of the park. In park we have slide, swing, and some seesaw and some benches.
And so many animals, and so many slides, and so many swing. Animals respond, and everyone enjoy. Thank you.
Reproduction.
nest. Third is sparrow nest, which is holes within building. Thank you. Hope like my models of nests.
Living room where my family watch TV and I play with my sister, lay down on the couch and then take a rest on the couch. This is my kitchen where my dad and mom cooks food and I help them. And this is the bedroom where my family sleep. This is the bathroom where my family do bath, bush, and brush their teeth. And this is the garden where I play and put water on the flower. So, and night there also in the kitchen there's also dining room there. And so this is my pool on my house, but there's fire.
Good morning everyone, my name is Mayur Prasad. Today I'm going to take you to my wildlife sanctuary. Wild animals live in the jungle. They roam around to hunt food. Some wild animals are very dangerous.
bottle. Make a hole at the bottom. Cover the hole with cotton and cover the hole with a layer of cotton. And cover the cotton with a layer of fat. And cover the fat with a layer of gravel. And pour the dirty water. And clean water, this is ready.
Did you look at the moon last night? And the night before? Was it the same shape? No, right? These different shapes are called the moon's faces.
Everybody is a home to a healthy mind. And to a healthy body, we must maintain cleanliness and personal hygiene.
The sun is a star. It also has a massive hot gas, which gives us heat and light. Every substance in the solar system revolves around the sun.
The moons of the planets are also the parts of the solar system. The planets go around the sun in circular parts are called orbits. The inner planets are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars. The outer planets are Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, Pluto.
Hello everyone, I'm Maya Knight from Glentree Glentree Academy, Whitefield. In my project, I had to use scissors and pencils to depict the rocket. How fuel powers the rocket? Scissors and pulses gives us energy to stay healthy and fit. As you can see here, cereals like ragi, maize, rice, wheat. Pulses like chana dal, masoor dal, moong ground, moong dal, chana. We all know that cereals are rich in carbohydrate and pulses are rich in protein. So we should use more and more cereals and pulses in our daily diet. Thank you.
Hello everyone. I am Vedant Mishra. I study in grade 2A. Today I am going to do a show and tell on food grains. I have also prepared a chart on it. There are two types of food grains, cereals and pulses. Cereals and pulses are small, dry and hard seeds. These are consumed as food by humans and animals. The nutrition value of cereals and pulses is used to maintain a healthy diet. I would now like to state some differences between the two. Cereals are highly produced, while the production of pulses is less compared to cereals. Cereals are highly rich in carbohydrates. Pulses are rich in protein. Cereals are the grasses. Pulses are the leguminous. Examples of cereals are wheat, rice, barley, and maize. Examples of pulses are green gram, black gram, kidney beans. I have prepared this chart showing cereals and pulses. Let us see the cereals first. Barley, rich in nutrients, boosts immune system. White rice, easy to digest, powerhouse of energy. Wheat, major source of starch and energy. Maize, rich in vitamin C, good for eye health. Now, coming to pulses, brown lentil, black gram, kidney beans, black chickpea, pigeon pea, green gram, split chickpeas are the examples of pulses.
Everybody, my name is Rukshanda. I am studying 2nd standard A section. My school name is Glentree Academy. Today I am going to tell about pulses and cereals. What are cereals? Cereals are rice, wheat, corn and bajra. Cereals are our main food. This is rice. This is wheat. This is bajra. And this is corn. Now pulse. We also get pulse from plants. What are pulse? Seeds of some plants are called pulses. This is kidney beans, this is green gram, and this is chana. Thank you.
Hello friends, I'm Girag Mohapatra. I am in grade 2A. Today I am going to tell you about medicinal plants. You all know that we have so many plants around us. Some plants give us medicines. Tulsi is used to cure cough and cold. Cloves are used to treat toothache.
is also used in soaps and toothpastes. Turmeric is an antioxidant. It helps in healing wounds. Urinary diseases and skin cancer. Garlic is also used to treat bronchitis, liver disorders, diabetes and intestinal worms. Thank you.
Talk about different types of spices. Spices adds color and flavor to the food. Spices can be flowers, seeds, bark, and stems. Spices are good for our health. Now I'm going to show you different types of spices. Cumin, clove, cinnamon, fenugreek, red chili, bay leaf, turmeric, fennel, star anise, cardamom, black pepper, coriander seeds, mustard seeds. Thank you.
Hello everyone, this is Prajan. Explain the story of seed. First step. Seed, sprout, seeding, plant, flower. Thank you.
After I did, I have put this in a bowl and this is how it looks.
Hello everyone, my name is Aditya. Today I made a helicopter using two matchboxes, a few matchsticks and one battery, two wires and a motor and a fan. Let me show you how does it work. You have to take the wire and put it over here. I have to put this wire over here so that this fan starts spinning. Now I'll show you how the helicopter moves. It's moving. I also made this card using cardboard, color paper, four bottle caps and two straws, one small tube and a balloon. Let me show you how it moves.
At my house. This should
should be kept at an easy to reach place. I request you all to keep this at your home. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Goran from grade 2B. Today I'm going to tell you about homes of wild animals. Wild animals live in the jungle. They are dangerous to humans, so we never disturb them in the wild. There are different wild animals like tiger, hippopotamus, elephant, giraffe, and lion. This is a waterfall. This is a river. There's a lot of greenery. This is a lion's den. The lion lives in the den. The den protects the lion from wind, cold, and rain. Hope you liked my project. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Nasya. I'm studying 2C section, Glentree Academy. I'm making two white animals house. One is den, one is a stable.
Good morning everyone, my name is Cheshishwini. Today I am going to speak about topic food groups. There are three types of food groups. The first one is protective food. Here are few examples of protective food. Protective food gives us vitamins and minerals needed by the body. The second food is bodybuilding food. Bodybuilding food gives us protein. Here are few examples of bodybuilding food. And the last one is energy giving food. Here are few examples of energy giving food. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Kavish Chauhan. I study in grade 2B. Today I'm talking about exercise and yoga. First, I'll show you yoga and exercise. This yoga is called Vajrasana. Now I'll show you an exercise. This exercise is called jumping jacks. Yoga and exercise make us fit, flexible, and energetic. Yoga and exercise increases our immunity and stamina. 45 minutes of daily exercise make us healthy and cure many diseases. Yoga works on PMS system, where P stands for physical, M stands for mental, and S stands for spiritual. Yoga can cure any small to big disease. It gives peace, clarity, and self-awareness to our body. It's better for everyone to practice yoga and exercise for a happy and healthy life. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Minalini E.R. I am studying in grade 2C. This is a model of a human skeleton. Skeleton is a framework of a human body. Skeleton has 206 bones and 360 joints. It gives shape to the body and it covers and protects the soft inner parts. For example, skull protects and covers the brain. Ribs protects the lungs and heart. Thank you.
Hello everybody, good morning. My name is Elsa. Today I am going to tell you about sense organs. I have made a model to show you about sense organs. There are five sense organs. It's right here. First one is eyes. Eyes helps us to see. Second one is tongue. Tongue helps us to taste. Third one is skin. Skin helps us to feel. And the fourth one is nose. Nose helps us to smell. Fifth one is ears. Ears helps us to hear. These are the five sense organs. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Zahir. I study in grade 2C. My school name is Glentree Academy. Today I talk about sense organs. We have five sense organs. First is eyes. Second is ears. Third is nose. Fourth is tongue. And last one is skin. Eyes help us to see. Ears help us to hear. Nose help us to smell. Tongue help us to taste. Skin help us to feel. I repeated. Eyes help us to see. Ears help us to hear. Nose help us to smell. Tongue help us to taste. Skin help us to feel. These are five sense organs. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Kate, studying grade 1 at Glentree Academy, Whitefield. So today I am going to discuss about different forms of water. In general, water is in liquid form. This is called liquid. The center of us. Two thirds of Earth is occupied by liquid form of water. When we heat the water above 100 degrees centigrade, liquid water converts into gases. We call that water vapor. So now some water vapors are coming. You see, water vapors. This smoke is called water vapor. We call it as water vapor. Some people call it as gas. I'll show you some water vapor. Here we go. Some people call it as gas. We call it as water vapor and gaseous. We call it sometimes as gas. Now, enough of saying the water vapor. When we cool the water below 0 degree centigrade, water converts into solid form. We call it as ice. can't see it right now. It's left. And look at the water, it has melted. It's a fun to play with it. But it's about. There are three different forms of water. Solid, liquid, and gas. Thank you.
This is my water filter. It has cotton at the bottom, sand, charcoal, and rock. Now, I'll show you how my water filter works.
This is my water filter setup.
This is metal, this is charcoal, this is sand, this is sponge.
Pebble filter, jelly mats. Charcoal will filter dirt. Sand will filter dust. Sponge will filter fine dust. Pure water collected here. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Anviksha Parmar. I study in class 2nd. I am making water filter. This is my water bottle. And this is cotton. This is stone. And this is charcoal. And this
water.
Hello everyone, my name is Anviksha Parmar. I am showing water filter. Now I am telling about water filter. The first layer of the water filter is cotton, and second layer of the water filter is sand, and third layer of the water filter is stone. Fourth layer of the water filter is charcoal. Now I am putting dirty water. Inside the water filter. Now you can see down clean water is coming down. Thank you.
Good morning everybody. My name is Anvika. I'm from class 2D. I'm going to explain some methods how to save the water. Water is awesome. We need to save the water. We should always take a shorter shower. Keep a timer. We should turn off the tap when we brush. Keep the water in a mug. We should immediately fix the leaks as soon as it is possible. Use a flex of taro water to wash cars and bikes. Save the water in a container or a bucket. Recycle the water. There is only one way to recycle the water: rain harvesting. We can also use the water for planting. Thank you.
My name is Disha Marji. I'm in class 2D. Today I am going to discuss about teeth. I have made a dummy teeth set to explain. Teeth are very important for our body, which helps us in chewing the food. We need to take care of our teeth by brushing 2 times a day. Avoid junk food. Eat lots of vegetables and fruits. It keeps us healthy. Keep strong and healthy. Thank you.
Respected teachers and my dear friends, my name is Nikhila Todi and I made a teeth model here. And I have 20 teeth, 10 on the top, 10 on the bottom. Children usually have around 20 baby teeth. Grown-ups have around 32 adult teeth. Brush your teeth at least 2 times a day. Eat a lot of healthy foods. Drink plenty of milk. You should spend 2 to 3 minutes brushing your teeth. Thank you.
Project on types of houses. Houses protect us from rain, storm, thieves, and wild animals. The houses in the villages are made of mud, straw, and wood called kacha houses. Houses in the cities are made of cement and bricks called paka houses. Nowadays, people live in tall buildings called the skyscraper. in very cold places, people live in houses made of blocks of ice called an igloo. For people who keep moving one place to another, like temporary houses like tents for campers and houseboats for that floats on the water. Thank you.
My name is Lakit Gora. I'm studying in 7th standard E section. My school name is Glentree Academy. Today's my topic is day and night. The rotation of earth cases day and night. The earth rotation on eight sides. One side of the earth faces the sun and the white light. This part of the earth as day. The another side of the earth does not receive light. This part of the earth as night. 24 hours one day, 12 hours day and 12 hours night. In this way, the rotation of the earth cases day and night. The day receives sun, clouds and wind. The night receives moon, stars and some flies.
It is a great honor for me to introduce and welcome our chief guest, Mrs. Sowmya, principal of Glentree Academy, Sarjapur. Ma'am, we are happy for your esteemed presence in today's program. An inspirational message can provide motivation to whoever reads or listens to it. Bright words can lift spirits or even spur people to make resolute life changes. Now, I request our guest of honor to address the gathering.
Thank you, Rachel John. Can you all hear me?
Yes, Sowmya, we can hear you.
Yes. Thanks for confirming that. I'm just overwhelmed, and you know, it has been like really wonderful. First of all, my hearty congratulations to all the students and the teachers who have made this happen. Good morning, dear parents, my dear students and teachers. Today, Glentree has shown that nothing stops them. We are still in the virtual mode. Things are slowly coming back to normalcy, but not fully. But that has not stopped us from anything. So it is a highly commendable job what the children have done today. I was when I was watching all the experiments and all the models and everything the children were explaining, I was trying to, you know, make a note of, okay, what are all the topics these children are covering? Trust me, I have some like 50 topics here now. Right from types of insects, animals, park, wildlife sanctuary, parts of the body, parts of plants, balancing, water purification, phases of moon, cleanliness, hygiene, types of fiber, sinking and floating, pet and farm animals, solar system, salad making, different types of spices, helicopter functioning, that was amazing. First aid box, food group, sense organ, yoga display, forms of water, seatbelt safety. The list goes on and on and on. You have not left any topic that is not covered. So every aspect of science you have beautifully covered, children. And the effort the children have put in making the models, I'm sure it is not just the children's effort, but also the parents' effort is so evident in it. And many children presented it in a very meticulous manner. And the models are perfect, flawless. You know, I wish it was a real exhibition. We could have seen and touched the model and we could have, you know, seen that in person. It would have given us more joy. But hopefully for the next academic year, we should be having this. Probably we can replicate this, you know, which the children will also be motivated more. And all the children, when they were like, I'm sure some of the videos are recorded, some could have been live also. But all the children, they didn't have any apprehension while talking on the video, while, you know, it was flawless. Children were very bold and very courageous, clearly put across what they have done. And so many children introduced themselves very nicely. And, you know, they probably like, you know, they're all, we are, you know, like this generation, we are, I mean, my generation and some of the teachers, you know, we are all digital migrants. We are slowly migrating to the digital world. But today, Glentree children proved that they are all digital natives. They are there already. And they presented it so meticulously. I'm really happy that I was able to be part of this grade 1, 2, 3 science virtual exhibition. Thanks, Ratna ma'am, for having me here. And thank you so much, all the teachers and children. And I wish the rest of the show also continues in the same manner with full enthusiasm and vigor. Good luck to all the children of Glentree Academy. And thank you for having me here. Thanks again.
Thank you so much, Sowmya, to be a part of our program today. It was a pleasure.
It was my pleasure.
Yes, same here. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Feedback is the breakfast for the champions. Let's hear it out from our very own parents.
Hi everyone, I am Ravi Aleti. My daughter Tamir Aleti is studying in Glentree Academy, 3rd standard A section. And she is in the school for 4 years. And as a parent, at least, you know, we never had any issues. We always have very good, relationship with management, teaching staff, or even class teachers are really good. And in particular, Tamir is really enjoying the school and she has made a lot of friends. And she also made a good relationship with all her class teachers and teaching staff. I'm quite happy as a father. Thank you very much.
We are proud parents of Hariti, who is associated with one of the best schools in Bangalore, Glentree Academy, Whitefield. This year is the first year of her primary school, where there is a lot to learn new things, and one of it is the science exhibition. That too online in the pandemic phase. Archana Gupta ma'am, her science teacher, made things so easier for her. She was able to understand what has to be done in the project, how it has to be done, and it was a great learning experience for her because she could put her imagination into the live project and she learned how to do the things step by step herself, which is, I think, the achievement for such a young girl. And I hope this learning continues. And best wishes to the school. Thank you for involving every kid in this science exhibition and making learning fun. Thank you.
We thank you for being with us today. Heartfelt thanks goes out to all our students, teachers, and parents for guiding and motivating us. Now, I would now like to invite Nirupama ma'am to give a vote of thanks.
Good morning to one and all present here. A warm and graceful morning to our honorable chief guest, Mrs. Sowmya ma'am, management committee, wonderful teachers, parents, my dear friends, and everyone gathered here. It's my privilege to propose the vote of thanks and acknowledge the contribution of those who worked really hard to make this virtual science exhibition possible. I, Nirupama, on behalf of Glentree Academy and the entire fraternity of the institution, extend my most sincere thanks to the Almighty God for making today's event a resounding success. With His blessings and grace, we are able to make this event what it was. On behalf of my school, I heartily thank our chief guest, Mrs. Sowmya Ma'am, who graced the occasion. Ma'am, your thoughts have enlightened our minds and have shown us a new path. I am sure this will inspire us in our future endeavors. I also thank our respected acting principal, Mrs. Ratna Ma'am, for encouraging us to do our best. An event like this cannot happen overnight. We have been fortunate enough to be backed by a team of very proactive and dedicated staff of our institution who are well-versed in their job. With a deep sense of appreciation, I thank our loving teachers and the people who work behind the scene, our technical arrangement team, for their untiring efforts in making this event a success. I thank Inya for her efforts towards anchoring today's event. Our sincere gratitude goes to all parents, well-wishers, and our budding rock stars for your rock-solid support, encouragement, and hard work. Without your support, we would not be able to achieve excellence. Thank you so much for attending this event. Last but not the least, we value you and every moment that you stay in this temple of learning. Thank you.